mai, piki mai, whakatau mai ki tēnei kōrero. Ko te mihi tuatahi me weke te atua, te whare e tū nei, tēnā koe. Te marae e takoto nei, tēnā koe. E nā rangatira nā whaia tēnā koutou. Ki te honga mate, haere koutou, haere, haere, haere. Ki te honga ora, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, kia ora nā tātou katoa. Welcome to this first lecture in memory of Sir Paul Reeves. I'm Chris Laidlaw. My first duty tonight is to read a message just received from the Governor General. He says, "Tonight begins the tradition that honours New Zealand's 15th Governor General, the first cleric and Governor General of Maori descent, Sir Paul Reeves, a great man who left an enduring legacy. Sir Paul, an Anglican Archbishop, carried out his role as Governor General in the same way as he had as a bishop, standing alongside people and searching for common ground. He was a man of action and a man of compassion and humility, always reaching out to the community he so valued. As Governor General, I wish to acknowledge the importance of this memorial lecture as a fitting tribute to a truly inspirational man and an outstanding New Zealander. Additionally, I also wish to thank Dame Anne Salmon for giving this inaugural lecture. The message you will deliver seems to me to be very much in harmony with the ethos of the late Sir Paul Reeves, searching for common ground in a society often focused on the more superficial issues. I also applaud Leadership New Zealand and the Auckland University of Technology for dedicating this annual lecture series to a man who gave so much of himself to the country and people he loved, Sir Jerry Mataparai. Paul Alfred Reeves was born in Wellington on the 6th of December 1932 of Maori and European descent. Graduating from Victoria University, he then studied at St John's Theological College in Auckland. He became Bishop of Auckland in 1979, Archbishop and Primate of New Zealand in 1980, Governor General of New Zealand in 1985, Chancellor of AUT University in 2000, and he was also an advisory trustee and a very valued one of Leadership New Zealand. He died, sad, on August the 14th, 2011, leaving Beverly, Lady Reeves, and three daughters, Sarah, Jane, and Bridget, and six grandchildren. This event is supported by the organisations at the very heart of Paul's life, the Anglican Church, AUT University, former Governor General Dame Catherine Tizard, the Maori people everywhere, and Leadership New Zealand, representing the broad diversity of the New Zealand community. We should acknowledge them all, and of course, the church for this great venue. Paul was in his own way all things to all New Zealanders. He was compassionate, and yet he had great reserves of toughness. He was dedicated and practical. He was dignified, yet intensely egalitarian, classless. He was pragmatic when pragmatism was called for. He was courageous, never ducking a scrap, even occasionally with David Longhi. He walked comfortably in the Maori and Pākehā worlds, and he could be very, very funny. I remember him telling the story of how he learned how to swim. His father, he said, took him down, I think, to Island Bay, to the Arctic waters of Island Bay, and just threw him in. And he just kept throwing him in. He threw him in again and again and again. And eventually, of course, Paul learned how to swim. The hardest part, he said, was getting out of the sugar sack.